Keep smiling.
Now, we thought it was about time to pay a visit to our friends over in the Big Mouth studio. It's resident genii, Matthew Horne and James Corden, everyone.
Dermatator.
Dermatologica. Hi, baby.
Hi, dudes, what's happening?
All right, boy.
Don't leave that one hanging.
I never would.
Oh,
it's there for me, I'm going to take it. So, only a week in the summer, and then 3 weeks now. How are you enjoying it?
Good. It's harder, isn't it?
Yeah, it's great, though.
Yeah, it's big fun.
Who's been your favourite hijacker so far?
Oh, I'm still Lucas.
I'm Lucas.
Matt.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, definitely.
He's been brilliant. He was absolutely brilliant, but you don't think anyone's sort of put the bar up there?
No one's been as funny, for me personally. Like, that first night, the opening night, was, I think, the best opening night
of Big
Brother.
It was so lovely and warm as well, which is so
it was lovely
so
and warm,
as well. OK, we're talking about Amy on our show today. Amy has emerged as the new house hottie. Are either you attracted to her? I'm thinking Horneo, that is your bag.
Yeah, you reckon?
Yeah, really? You and Amy, definitely. You're like a...
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, she's fit.
A conceptual artist, though,
quite
I imagine.
Serious.
Quite serious.
She needs a funny guy to start hanging out with.
But then that's why her and Matt would never work.
If you could get her to clean any square, Northern Hemisphere, what would that square be? Any...
Leicester Square, it's a dump.
I've got a square.
You help me out at all?
I've got a square.
Seems to be leaving me hanging.
I've got a square next to my bed, which has got, there's like a remote, a DVD box, a cup, and then sort of on the edge of the square, there's like a plate with some crumbs on it.
That'd it makes great. A square, doesn't it?
That would be great if she could clean that. That's almost all my flat needs at the minute.
There's a place for her around your flat next to your bed. That's
not
saying.
Not like that.
Anyone else in the house doing it for you? I'm thinking you are kind of a Kalista kind of a guy.
It's so weird that you said that because she's only started to become attractive to me recently.
Okay, go on.
I don't know why. I think it's now only because Anthony wants her. That's made me want her more.
You've literally just opened the door into every man's mind.
I've seen it and I thought, well, you're a boxer. I'll never be able to have you in a fight, but I'll take her off your hands.
What about Amelia? Do we like Amelia over in the Big Mouth?
Yeah, always. Yeah.
He's
yeah.
got some...
Some of those cutaways of her doing a shizzle.
Yeah.
Is incredible.
Amazing.
Are you looking forward to meeting Amelia when she comes out, Horneo?
Well, no, because we met her mum or auntie. So they didn't like us.
Did they not?
No. We had her mum on the phone on the show.
I saw
and we talked to her and then...
Sort of cut her off. They
it wasn't
sort of
your talking, fault. There was
no,
a guy.
But they were talking in our ear going, right, you've got to cut her off now. You've got to, you know, so she ended up going, all right, thanks, bye. And she wasn't very happy about that. Well, not so much her, it was the auntie, wasn't it?
Yeah, we went to apologise.
We went over to say a proper sorry.
Yeah.
You know, and...
The eyes were burning.
Oh, okay. God, it wasn't nice. Yeah.
And who do you think deserves to join Victor? Well, I can tell you who's going to join Victor. Amelia, Liam, and Jeremy.
Wow.
Thoughts on that? Who do you think...
Liam's getting a bit of a rough ride, isn't he, Liam, at the moment, I think. Mm-hmm.
But they're a little clique, aren't they? Amelia, Victor, and Jeremy. They're a little sort of gang of their own. So I wonder... Because I was quite surprised when Victor stayed on Friday, so... I'm not sure what he's doing for people at home, but obviously something. So I wonder, I think it's a straight shootout between him and Liam.
Are you enjoying the series in terms of the people who got in there?
I think it's all dependent on the hijacker, really, isn't it? And so it changes from day to day.
I would have agreed with you up till yesterday, and now I think they've started to become the right people.
Yeah, it feels like it's just starting to bubble under with some chemistry and stuff like that. And I think it's, you know, in that, I think... They haven't had, I think because they're perhaps a bit brighter or whatever, there isn't that kind of instant, oh my God, we're best friends, we're best friends forever, no we're not, I hate you. Everyone's been a bit like that, but I think they're starting to actually form some proper friendships. So that's going to make it more exciting for the next couple of weeks, I think.
Loving you, boys.
Oh,
good luck tonight.
Oh, God.
Take it easy.
Oh, God.
Coming up in part two, we're going to be getting an exclusive from the boyfriend of the girl. Everyone's talking about Amy's
other half,
Tom. Love
you, Dermot, so much.
Do not miss it. See you in four. One more shot of those.
Incredible.
Amazing.
All going on in here. Welcome back, it's day 13. The time is 7:49, just gone. Still to come, we're gonna be delving into all things Amy, her F&F are here, but first, some culture, as we go behind the scenes with yesterday's hijacker, Brian Saul.
Hello. Is it that stuff?
Yes.
Do you want them?
Am I really wearing something that Janet Street Porter has worn?
We've cleaned them.
Ah! Oh!
I hate being old. My name is Brian Sewell. Your task is to construct a dinner.
Can we not buy the packeted cream spinach?
No.
No, 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 no. Spinach is a deceitful vegetable. Yes. Oh, sorry. Yeah.
Take that silly thing off your head.
And I suppose one has to be slightly computer literate to understand all these buttons, which I am not. I don't think I'm audible. There is no reaction. Is there? Yes, there is. What most interests you when you're not being a singer-songwriter?
I'm not a singer-songwriter.
You're not? I'm looking at the wrong person. Amy.
Yes?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Right, I can't hear you. Fine. Well, I've thoroughly enjoyed the day, but I'm not at all sure about the housemates. I don't think they quite know what to make either of me or of the task, so we shall see.
There we go. Now, for a self-confessed former Ming troll, Amy's attracting rather a lot of attention since she went into the house. Everyone seems to love her, and as great as she is, there's something we just can't explain about it. Just do not know why. Here to tell us more about the squeaky clean housemate who's turning thoughts dirty is Amy's sister, Julianne, and better mate, Nadia, everyone. Hello, Julianne. Hello, Nadia.
Hiya.
How are you?
Yeah, good, thanks.
Good, thank you.
OK, before we go any further, we're going to take a look at all the attention Amy's been attracting lately. Take a look.
You're the new nation's sweetheart in many ways, I think.
I'm sure.
Do you really like Amy? Do you fancy her?
Yeah, of course I do.
Amy is so fit.
Every day I look at her, she's getting hotter.
I don't know, seriously.
Seriously freaking me out.
How do you do it? I quite fancy Amy after today.
I just think you're a real talent, and I don't see how anyone else can really triumph in this competition. You're absolutely fantastic.
Look at those dangly earrings in the...
Who do you fancy in the house?
Amy.
Your effortless grace, your constant beauty, it walks with you. You're like a living poem, so I don't think you really have to try.
Let's just get married in the diary. Please. Can we get married?
Do you know what? She looks hot in that wig. Weirdly.
I saw Amy's face and it was like an inspiration to keep working on my body so I can have a body of a Greek god like her as a Greek goddess. We love you. Simple as.
There we go. Everyone loves Amy. Discuss, has she always had this effect on men?
I've been friends with Amy.